Health Department presents The Lonesome Traveler, starring Woody Guthrie as Rusty the Traveler.
Howdy. Sit down over here by the fire. Nice quiet place for a little guitar picking. That freight from San Antonio won't be along for quite a while yet. Got a nice fire going here, so sit down, take it easy, swap a couple of stories. My name's Rusty. Some folks sometimes call me the Lonesome Traveler. I'm just a lonesome traveler, the great historical bum. Highly educated, from history I have come. I built the Rock of Ages, 'twas the year of one. That's about the biggest thing that man has ever done. I was a straw boss on the pyramid and the Tower of Babel too. I sailed with Chris Columbus in 1492. Fought the battle at Valley Forge and battle at Bully Run. That's about the biggest thing that man has ever done. Hitler's dead and buried 'cause he got too fresh with me. Einstein learned to split that atom on my knee. We found a cure for syphilis now, and when the battle's won, that'll be one of the biggest things that man has ever done. Now, maybe not every word of that song is strictly and absolutely true, but the main idea of it is. The big shots make history, but us little guys have got to take the consequences. Scientists have discovered how to split the atom and get the energy out of it, but the energy can kill us all or make a better life for everybody. I mean, it's me and you and Mary Jane that uses or abuses these scientific inventions. Now the doctors have found some new ways of curing this syphilis, that terrible disease. But what'll be the final result? Well, that's up to you and me. One person with that disease is more dangerous than a mad dog. Maybe you think I'm exaggerating, but in my years of hoboing, I've seen a thing or two about this syphilis. I've seen a lot of this human tribe, every color, flavor, and size. One scared me so bad I can't forget. She had lips of cherry and eyes of jet. And our Frisco bar rooms where we met. It was in the sad saloon at the clouding of the moon. I sat down to drink my cares away. In that old cracked mirror glass, I first saw her dancing past. She caught my eye, she smiled and looked away. Not a soul knew me in town, just a tramp and outward bound. I did ache to feel her hot hand touching mine. When she touched me on the neck, saying, "Partner, buy the drinks," her hand felt colder than the night outside.
What are you drinking?
The same.
Waiter, two drinks for two little bums. You want to dance?
My feet feel like hamburger steaks already.
Ah, you talk like an Okie.
Yeah, I'm from that part of the country.
Say, I know you. I've seen you before.
How'd
Why,
you know my...
You're Rusty.
How'd you know my name?
Well, I'm from your hometown. You used to play with your sisters. Don't you remember Alvy?
Oh, the one they used to call Skinny Marie.
Yeah, that's me.
You certainly filled out.
Well, Rusty, tell me all about yourself. How's the old town? How's Bessie? And you remember that little brown dog we used to have? So, that was when I just couldn't stay with my folks any longer. Nothing to stay for. And I took this job because about all I knew was to dance. Somehow it just got harder and harder to leave.
Well, everybody's got to eat.
But that's not why I'm staying here now.
Maybe you got to like it.
I hate it. especially the men.
That don't make sense to me. You're a hostess and hate the men.
Look, the first guy I went with, he made me think he liked me. And I loved him. And then suddenly he left me flat and went away with another woman. But that wasn't all he did. After a while, I realized he'd left me with one of those diseases.
Did you go see a doctor?
Nah. I thought about it for a while, but then it didn't bother me anymore. And I kept thinking, these men, how I hate them. What if I have got it? So what if I do give it to them? See, Rusty, it's my revenge on them. I'm little Alvy, and I'm poison, see? Well, don't you want to put your arms around me, Rusty? Where are you going, Rusty?
Obviously.
Don't go, Rusty. Yeah, you afraid? Come on back. What are you running away for, huh?
Well, I got out of that place fast, and I moved on. Little Alvy. You know, if I'd have known then what I know now, I'd have got her to a doctor quick. But then I hadn't yet seen what the syphilis can do. I did see it later, though, one night that I'll never forget. I was booked for vagrancy in the Durand, Oklahoma jail. Oh, the Durand jail beats no jail at all. If you want to catch hell, go to Wichita Falls. It's a hard times in the Durand jail. Hard times, poor boy. Straight from the free world and into a cell, just like a sailing from heaven to hell. It's hard times in the Durand jail. Hard times, poor boy.
Hey, come here, God. Hey, I want service. Hey, lazy, come on. I can get this up all night. I can holler even louder. Hey, God!
Okay, Moxie, okay. Maybe you want me to come in and give you a rub down with my stick.
You and your big brother.
Okay, Moxie, what's the matter?
How come you put this little fuss-faced punk in with me?
You mean him with the guitar?
Yeah, the kid, how come?
Well, he came in tonight, Moxie. Not an empty accommodation in this Hard Rock Hotel. So what am I going to do, turn a customer away? Just because I ain't got no place for him to sleep? Poor guy, I wouldn't do that to him. But we'll shove him along in the morning, okay?
Yeah, okay, but be sure you have him out early. I don't like nobody watching me while I eat my breakfast.
Hey, guard, what's the matter with him? Is he nuts?
No, he's just a murderer. Maybe he's a little off his rocker, then you know what they say. We're all a little cracked, right? Good night.
Night.
Hey, you. What are you in for?
Vagrancy.
Hey, listen. I seen you somewhere before.
Yeah? I ain't never been here before.
Yeah, I seen you.
I ain't never seen this town till 2 hours ago.
Kid, you kidding? I know you. Moxie knows you. I never forget a face. Now, come clean.
I'm not telling you. I just come in here from California.
What they put you in here for, huh? How much are they paying you?
I'm in jail, just like you. Can't you
now
see?
Now, quit stalling. I'll spill.
Huh?
You're a stoolie. You're a dirty stoolie, aren't you, huh?
Okay, I am a stoolie.
You know too much. You know what I'm going to do to stoolies? Me. The same as I give that other
help.
One.
Help.
It's too late now for help.
Help.
I'll beat you to death against these bars. That's what I'll do. I'll beat you to death. Stoolie, it's good.
Well, I see my patient's awake.
Where am I?
A hospital.
What happened?
That Moxie nearly beat you to death. The guard just got there in time.
Well, I ache all over.
Well, I guess he tried to break you to pieces.
What's eating that guy? I never had seen him before.
He went insane. You were the object of his insane rage.
I didn't say anything.
The poor guy has paresis.
What's that?
It's a brain infection from syphilis. A man can have syphilis in his system for years and not even know it. Then sometimes the germ gets to work on your brain. After many years, without much warning, man can go mad. That's what happened to him.
I met some people with syphilis. At least they thought they had it.
Well, the ones who don't know they have it but do, they're even more dangerous. Anytime you meet anybody who may have syphilis, you get them to a doctor for a checkup.
Yeah, I sure will.
Well, now, you'd better get some sleep. Get over. Moxie's beaten. See you again tomorrow.
Okay, Doc.
St. Louis on the M&O. A hard road, but I gotta go. Catch the Pensy on the fly. Pittsburgh mama, don't you cry. Ride the seaboard on the blind. Miami water tastes like wine. Mobile, Alabama, Baton Rouge, Louisiana. San Francisco, San Antonio. Empty boxcar, my home. Empty boxcar, my home. Empty boxcar, my home.
I remember one day I was sitting in an empty boxcar way out in the Mesquite Flats somewhere, waiting for the freight to move on. There was a young kid crawled up in the where with me and seemed like he was all excited about something.
Boy, am I relieved. Am I glad.
What about?
Going home. I'm headed back home.
Did you run away from home?
Yeah, I did a few months ago, but I'm going back now.
What'd you run away from?
Oh, I got mixed up with a girl, and I thought I'd got a disease. I sure was scared. Had kind of a sore and then a rash, little spots in my face and hands. Couldn't face my family or anyone. So I hit the road. But then the spots began to go away, and pretty soon they were all gone.
Hmm. That may not mean a thing.
Yeah, but they're all gone, so I guess I'm all right.
Don't be too sure.
I never meant to get mixed up with that girl anyway. I'd had a fight with the girl I was meaning to marry, and, well, I took a few drinks.
You better get off this train quick.
What do you mean?
You thinking of going back there and making up with your girl?
Why not? Tell you I'm all right.
Well, it's what a lot of people have thought. Listen, I'll give it to you quick because this train's pulling out here. I had some long talks with the doctor about this stuff. Those spots always go away, but then the germ stays inside you. Unless you get the right treatment.
Hey, you sure?
Then one day just like that, it can do bad things to you. You might have a baby born sick or dead. You get yourself to a doctor because he'll give you a blood test, and that's the only sure way that you can tell.
Yeah, but I haven't got any money.
Then get to a clinic. They'll cure you. You think they want you running around like this, but get cured here, now, before you go back home.
Yeah, I better.
Jump off of here, man. Quick.
Thanks. Say, what's your name?
Rusty.
Thanks, Rusty. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
So long.
Just a lonesome traveler, the great historical bum. Highly educated, from history I've come. I'm the man that signed the contract to raise the rising sun. That's about the biggest thing that man's ever done. I cured the plague that wrecked the towns and nations did I heal. Bubonic plague and bloody flux and rats with poison tails. Malaria from mosquito bites and chili fever runs. That's about the biggest thing that man had ever done. Well, I guess the toughest battle was to find the syphilis cure. Now the doctors have the stuff that kills the bug for sure. I guess it's up to me now and when the battle's won. That'll be one of the biggest things that man has ever done.
I've heard The Lonesome Traveler, starring Woody Guthrie as Rusty the Traveler, and written and directed by Alan Lomax. This program was produced for the health departments of the nation by the Communication Materials Center at Columbia University.
Traveling